this is what the economic map should look like. And there's much to do if you wish to tap into the economic potential here. For instance, of a potential fish resource of 5.3 million metric tons in India's maritime zone, only about 70% is fished. 90% of this catch comes from fishing up to just the 50-meter contour line, highlighting opportunities for deep-sea fishing. India's offshore wind energy generation potential is more than 300 gigawatts, one-tenth of which is currently planned to be tapped. Large marine ecosystems in the Bay of Bengal comprise 8% of the world's coral reefs and 12% of mangroves, opening opportunities for coral reef tourism apart from ecological conservation. And while the blue economy contributes about 4% to India's GDP, I think there's tremendous potential to expand its contribution. And I'm sure that the panelists would explore these dimensions and developments related to India and the region at large. The Honorable Prime Minister of India has laid emphasis. You can pick away the map now. The Honorable Prime Minister of India has laid emphasis on India's emerging as one of the leading blue economies of the world, with all maritime stakeholders joining hands to achieve this task. And the Navy is a key stakeholder in realizing this vision, and its strength lies in ensuring safety, security, good order at sea. And this is critical to enable commerce and trade to thrive in a stable and sustainable manner. So the Navy's efforts are aimed to contribute to the core objectives of the UN Sustainable Development Goal 14, which is to preserve, protect, and conserve ocean spaces and resources. So being a practitioner, I would like to offer some thoughts now on how we in the Indian Navy are focusing on securing the blue economy, which is the topic of today's webinar. In this endeavor, the Navy aims to be both an enabler and an element of national and regional blue economy efforts. In terms of being the enabler, I'll highlight three ways in which the Navy contributes to the blue economy. First, of course, as Admiral Dhawan mentioned, is by maintaining a comprehensive maritime domain awareness. MDA is crucial if we are to develop greater understanding of what is happening at sea. This remains a challenge given the expanse. If you look at the Indian Ocean region itself, for instance, it is 20 times India's landmass. So our MDA efforts, in consonance with other countries, friendly foreign countries, are focused on preventing inimical activities at sea, and which can deprive nations of their rightful blue economic dividend.